So now I would like to invite the second speaker of this afternoon, George Chouliarakis, who is the alternate finance minister of Greece.
So thank you so much for the opportunity you have given us. And let me say again that it's a pleasure and an honor to be here in the Economist event. I'll say a few things about the state of play of the world economy and the key risks and challenges going forward. And then I will move on to discuss in a little bit more detail the state of play of the Greek economy in the near and medium term. So let me start with the good news. 10 years after the onset of the crisis, the cyclical recovery of most of the world economy is gaining momentum. Global output growth is projected to be 3.5% in 2017. These are IMF figures, and 3.6% in 2018. For most of the advanced market economies, growth will be also positive and significant. And this is especially true for the euro area, particularly Germany, Italy, and Spain, where so far growth has been sluggish and uneven. I will highlight four policy areas where significant progress has been made over the past 10 years during the period of the world economic crisis, but also where significant risks are still present. Let me start with the area where maybe more progress has been made. More policy responses across the world has been accommodative, coordinated, and effective, mainly referring to the coordination among the central banks of the euro area, the United States, and the United Kingdom, and helped sustain economic recovery initially with an aggressive reduction of interest rates, and when nominal rates reached the lower bound, the zero lower bound, with unconventional monetary policy tools, what we now know as quantitative easing. However, inflation still remains subdued, especially in the United States and the euro area. Inflation expectations are anchored below target, and therefore monetary policymakers should be cautious. Monetary policy should remain accommodative, and monetary policy normalization should proceed cautiously, maybe with a moderate degree of tapering, but without raising policy rates as yet, especially in the United States, that policymakers are now facing a new puzzle: extremely low unemployment by historical standards, but still very low subdued inflation. On the fiscal policy front, the fiscal policy record across the world has been rather uneven. In the United States, fiscal policy supported effectively economic recovery with an aggressive fiscal stimulus package in the first year of the Obama administration in 2009-2010, when fiscal multipliers were low, and with a moderate and steady consolidation thereafter. However, in the Eurozone as a whole, the fiscal stance was too tight over the years of the crisis, generating therefore negative spillover effects at a critical time for economic recovery, what people call, what we now know as coordinated austerity. The reason of this tight fiscal stance is the fact that although countries with no fiscal space, such as Greece, were obliged to and had to consolidate, countries with fiscal space did not have an incentive to expand. This is a key imbalance, a key asymmetry that needs to be corrected in the euro area going forward. We also need to reconsider a new public risk-sharing mechanism in the context of the European Monetary Union, and reconsider a new balance between fiscal discipline on one hand, a needed fiscal discipline, I should say, and flexibility on the other, to avoid repeating the same mistake of coordinated austerity that we went through in the past decade. At the same time, the European stability mechanism has to transform itself to a European monetary fund, a fund that will be able to negotiate the terms of any financing program in the future in the context of the European Monetary Union. Third, the financial sector still remains fragile, but more resilient than in the past and strengthening further, but more progress there needs to be made, especially on the banking union, and with the development of a deposit insurance scheme. On the other side of the Atlantic, in the United States, financial deregulation should be avoided at all costs, as the Federal Reserve made clear recently. Fourth, a fourth big global, I would say, risk stems from the stagnation of income growth for a big part of the population of the advanced market economies. This stagnation is driven both by technology and free trade. And unless this long-term trend is reversed, the free flow of people and free trade, both important components of long-term growth, will remain at risk, as we saw recently in Britain and in the United States. And here, fiscal policy has a very important role to play, creating space for the development and financing of new policy tools, such as the guaranteed minimum income, active labor market policies, and a progressive tax and benefit system. They are all key to maintain the health of liberal democracies. Let me now turn to Greece. Let me zoom into Greece. We are now entering the final year of the consolidation program, and we all need to acknowledge that a great deal has been achieved all across the key areas of the economy as the reforms started bearing fruit. Acute risks have subsided, uncertainty has been dispelled, and there is now a clear, credible, and visible way forward. The economic growth has been in positive territory for a fifth consecutive quarter, with the exception of quarter four of 2018. And we are confident that we are on track to meet the forecast of 1.8 year-on-year for 2017. Likewise, prospects for 2018 are good. Our baseline scenario predicts growth of 2.4%, driven by a significant rebound in private capital formation at the backdrop of several years of uncertainty-driven disinvestment. On the labor markets, unemployment is still extremely high, but falling. This year, unemployment rate will end at about 20%, and the projection for 2018 is for an unemployment rate a little below 19%, supporting, therefore, a moderate but steady household consumption growth. Maybe the most impressive record so far is in the area of fiscal consolidation, the root of the twin crisis that led to the crisis of 2010. On the fiscal front, Greece has overperformed the fiscal targets of both 2015 and 2016 for 2 years in a row, and we expect to do the same again in 2017, scoring maybe a primary fiscal surplus of a little bit above 2.2%. Our estimate of the structural primary surplus is 2.8% of GDP, and therefore we are confident that we'll also be able to easily meet the ambitious target of 3.5% next year. In the financial sector, the dispelling of uncertainty has led to an encouraging net inflow of deposits over the past few months, while banks are in the process of cleaning up their balance sheets. And this progress is also reflected in the steady fall of government bond yields, which now stand at a prohibitive but significantly lower than in the past rate of 5.5%. So at the back of this progress, Greece was able to exit again after 3 years to international capital markets successfully in July, exited the excessive deficit procedure of the European Commission, and has been upgraded by all credit rating agencies. As we now enter the final stretch of the mile, there is still plenty to do. Importantly, we need to avoid complacency and minimize risks towards a successful completion of the program. I will refer to three key steps we need to take going forward. First of all is the swift conclusion of the third review before the end of the year, so that we have a period of clean air starting from January 2018 to tap several times the international capital markets again towards the end of the program, build a significant cash buffer as an insurance mechanism for the post-program period, discuss with the European partners the landscape of the day after and the post-surveillance mechanism of the clean exit, and finally being able to specify in detail the medium-term debt relief measures that will be implemented gradually in the post-program period. Thank you.